Hey, it's Sean Patrick, afternoon show host from 98.5 KYGO. Brand new room we've got here. First time we've ever used it. I'm going to come up with a more creative name, but for now we'll call it the 98.5 KYGO Performance Studio because we're real creative. We're really excited to have Danielle Bradbery in as our very first artist. Her guitar player, Danielle.
Easy.
If I mess that up at some point throughout the day today, don't hate me for it. You might be Danielle at some point.
You're right.
Sorry. All right. You guys want to play some music for us to start things off?
Yeah, let's go.
You say you want me, and then you don't. One day you're whiskey hot, and then you beer cold. Sometimes you're in, sometimes you're out. Sometimes a girl gotta put her foot down. Stop dragging your boots up onto my porch. Kicking butt off your heels, knocking on my door. Thinking I let you leave and buy my bed on the floor. You ain't gonna crash your party here no more. You better get to walking if you don't want what you got. Either love me or not, just stop dragging your boots. Out in the sea, I can hear my mama telling me, cut them loose, throw them back if they play with your heart. There are plenty more boys at the bar. Stop dragging your boots up onto my porch, kicking butt off your heels, knocking on my door. Thinking now that you're leaving by my bed on the floor, you ain't gonna crash your party here no more. You better get to walking if you don't want what you got. Either love me or not, just stop dragging your boots. Dragging your boots. No. You're out of time, make up your mind. Dragging your boots up onto my porch, kicking mud off your heels, knocking on my door. Thinking now that you're leaving by my bed on the floor, you ain't gonna crash your party here no more. You better get to walking if you don't want what you got. Either love me or not, just stop dragging your boots.
You know what I've realized in this new studio that we have here
yes.
is that if we have it set up this way, it's going to be a little bit awkward for me and probably when I'm performing because I feel like I'm on an island.
You're just,
where am I supposed to look?
Right.
What do you do when you're performing? Obviously, you have a crowd in front of you normally.
Yeah.
Do you pick one person out or do you kind of look around?
Gosh.
What's going through your mind as far as what to look at when you're on stage?
It's so funny because I actually talked about this with somebody last night. It helps me because there's obviously a lot of people, but I don't look at anyone right in their face. Like if I look at the top of their head or like their ear or something, it looks like I'm looking at them,
right.
But I can't make eye contact. Or if I have that one person front row that's just not even looks like they're having the worst time of their life, I will focus on them for the rest of the night, and I can't help it. It's like it's either or. So
do they ever get the point? Like, do they ever
realize? I think so.
That?
Yeah. I've definitely called somebody out before for like being on their phone or whatever, because it's so, as a performer, you want everybody to have fun, you want them to, you know, loosen up, but then you have that one person. I'm like, come on.
Always one.
Yeah, always one.
So the voice is always going to be a part of your
yes.
story, obviously.
Yeah.
Was it 2013?
2013.
That's crazy that it's,
I know.
This is the 10-year anniversary. You have plans for that?
Oh, gosh. I mean, I should, shouldn't
yeah,
I? That's,
for sure.
That's
there needs to be an anniversary
10
party.
Years is insane. Yeah.
So if you look back on it, I'm sure you're asked this question a lot, and you've probably had time to reflect on it. Would you do it the same way?
I mean, honestly, yeah, because I wouldn't be here if it did any different. You know, if I picked a different coach, or you never know. I think what happened for a reason, and picked Blake. He was the perfect coach. And at the time, I'm like the 16-year-old girl singing all these older country songs, and some of them I didn't even know. Yeah. And I'm like, what is this? I want to sing the, like, Carrie Underwood and the Miranda Lambert, all that stuff. But he always said, trust me, sis, and obviously it worked out.
You still talk to Blake to this day?
We've talked here and there, but he's a busy man, obviously. Right. And, I mean, we end up linking back up every now and then, but it seems like he's doing great. And yeah, so it's been good.
Seems like you're doing great as well. Tonight is the night that the Jordan Davis tour starts. I know you're pumped up about it. We were talking about it before we started this whole thing. Talk about this tour compared to some of the other tours you've been on recently, and how things have changed for you.
Well, I actually just got to be on tour a little bit with Jordan, because we have his song Midnight Crisis. I got to be a feature on it. And he was just on the Luke Combs tour. And he was like, just come out and sing Midnight Crisis. And I'm like, that is the easiest, most fun tour ever. So I got to do that. That whole camp was incredible. And then obviously he asked me to do this tour. And it's just him and I. And like I said, that whole camp, Jordan himself, I'm such a huge fan. Like, our friendship, it's a whole thing. It's so fun. And I'm just so excited for it. And then I rebuilt my set and show a little bit for this tour and some stuff to come. And I'm just, there's a lot of newness. There's a lot of, it's just going to be so fun.
Tell me that Jordan Davis is the nicest human you've ever met.
He is the nicest human. Yes.
Confirm that fact.
Yeah, he confirmed. He's the most genuine and just all around cool dude. So, yeah.
Let's talk about music a little bit. Yeah. You put out an album last year. Mm-hmm. What are your plans for music going forward?
Yeah, so I am currently working on new music. I have a lot of them recorded. A lot of them still need to be recorded. And I just announced my first headline tour, and so a lot of that new music is going to be kind of in that set, and just there's a lot of newness, a lot of exciting things happening all at once, but it's really good.
That is good stuff, for sure.
Yes, yeah.
And you've got a new radio single coming out, A Special Place.
Yes.
Let's talk about that song. Is it a true story?
Well, there's a bunch of people that I can think of when I listen to that song, and obviously if you haven't heard it, it's a song that's basically about somebody or whoever it is that you don't really want to wish well, because, you know, they've treated you wrong, or it could be all across the board. It's just one of those where you gotta have one of those stick it to them songs.
For sure.
So,
and I feel like everybody's got that person.
1,000%.
Everyone can relate.
Not even just a relationship. Like, it could be at a workplace, or a friend, or anybody. And it's just, you know, there's a special place for you. So.
And before we wrap the interview portion up, I want to talk about tattoos a little bit.
Okay.
Recently, I saw an article that said Dolly Parton has a bunch of secret tattoos.
I've heard of that, too.
I really want to know.
I've never seen them. But, oh, my gosh. Well, I did read where her favorite is butterflies. So, I mean, I would guess. I don't know.
For sure. I would think she probably has some butterflies.
Yeah, right.
You've got some on your hand that
I
are visible. Let's talk about those.
I have a bunch of different ones a little everywhere. I mean, this one's in Spanish because my grandmother's from Mexico, and she always used to call my sister and I Mirena, which is my queen. So I got that on there. And there's just like a bunch of different. I got my Texas.
Right.
I got a lot of stuff, you know.
It makes how did the finger ones feel, like, from a pain
the,
standpoint?
The hand was probably the worst. Yeah.
Good
so
to know. Don't get a hand tattoo.
Right.
If you don't like
right.
All right. Enough about tattoos and all of that stuff. Let's play some more music.
All right. Well, this is A Special Place.
The room is hot and the pool is cold. The TV ain't got HBO. And the water pressure's always low. And the minibar is empty. And good luck getting a good night's sleep. Right between the honeymoon suite and the 1980s vending machine, where all they sell is Pepsi. So if your friends ask where to send your mail, there's a special place in hell, a zero-star hotel. with someone else. The concierge won't be no help. He's always on vacation. I don't hate you, but I sure don't wish you well. There's a special place. Could never hold a candle to the room that they got held for you. That special place in hell for you. There's a badly bathroom mirror. Take a long look at yourself. There's a special place in hell, a zero-star hotel. Don't worry about your stay, 'cause I've already paid. There's a special place in hell for you. All the heat you put me through could never hold a candle to the room that they got held for you. That special place in hell for you.
What a harsh song. Every time I'm like, dang.
Still, after all these times singing.
Right, exactly.
Danielle Bradbery, first artist ever in the KYGO Performance Studio. That'll have a cooler name next time you're here, I promise. You got time for one more?
Yes, all of right. Course. I'm going to throw it back to one of my favorites. This is Sway.
Hey, we're all in the same boat. Life can really suck sometimes. But hey, can't live in a shadow. So here's a little piece of advice. Stop by kicking off your shoes, even right by the door. Then you call a couple friends and you call a few more. Put a drink into your glass that'll make you let go. Then you find something smooth on the radio that makes you wanna sway to the left and sway to the right. Get lost in a groove that'll make you lose your mind. Put a smile on your face and you ride into a daze. No, there ain't nothing wrong when a song comes on that makes you wanna sway. Time for sitting around waiting for it to light up. Let's break some rules and figure it out. Stop by kicking off your shoes, even right by the door. Then you call a couple friends and you call a few more. Put a drink into your glass that'll make you let go. Then you find something smooth on the radio that makes you wanna sway to the left and sway to the right. Get lost in a groove that'll make you lose your mind. Put a smile on your face and you ride into a daze. No, there ain't nothing wrong when a song comes on that makes you wanna sway. Something that makes you wanna sway to the left and sway to the right. Get lost in a groove that make you lose your mind. Put a the smile on your face and you ride into a daze. No, there ain't nothing wrong when a song comes on that makes you wanna sway.
One more time, Danielle Bradbery inside the KYGO Performance Studio. Cannot wait to see you on tour with Jordan Davis. We'll see you
soon. Thank you. Yes.